And you're still three-fifths of a man in the Constitution of America, right? So actually, our people should be celebrating stuff like this because it has nothing to do with us.
I mean, I absolutely agree with you.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with us.
To prove what he was saying about
right, read that.
This is the you contend before and after the conquest, right?
It says, some old men of Yucatan said that they have heard from their ancestors that this country was peopled by a certain race who came out of the east, who blocked the river opening from the 12 roads to the sea. If this is true, all the inhabitants of the Indies must be Jewish descent, because the Straits of Magellan having been passed, they must have spread over more than 2,000 leagues of territory and now are governed by Spain.
Yeah,
I
agree.
This is a question. What is that book? This, right, if not the Bible, what is it referencing? How, I guess, how would I say, how do I know that it's historically accurate, per se, right?
Right, this is backed by scholars. This is actually outside sources from biblical prophecy and archaeology, right? This is some of the things that our scholars have got in to see the people to prove that they were from the east, right? Go ahead and read on, right?
This is origins of the American Indians,
right?
Concepts of 1492 to 1729, right? It says, the only other writer of that author who found accepted of the Issachar variation of the Tenloth tribes theory of Baltasar de Medina in La Cronica de la Santa Provincia de San Diego de Mexico in 1682, although Medina thought the South Americans of the Yucatans were descendants of the Gentile Inkin, father of the Ofer, the Mexicans are originally of the 10 tribes captured by Salamanca of the family of Issachar, whom the Indians recognize as their special ancestors.
Right, so now I'm gonna back that up with the Bible to show you that's in the Bible, right? Read that.
This is the second Esther chapter 13 and verse 40. Second Esther chapter 13 and verse 40. Chapter 13 and 40. It reads, those were the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea, when Shalmaneser, the king of Assyria, led away captive and led them over the water, which thereafter were brought into a strange land. But they took counsel among themselves that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country.
Right, real quick, so let me expound on this, right? This is where the
I really do have to be going, all right?
Hey, and next time, man, look it up, get into it, hey, man, and repent as an Israelite from the tribe of Issachar, man, right?
I guess I'm very uneducated, so I hate to make any specific comments, but I guess my personal, I guess, feeling is,
Well, God already said he only made the Israelites to serve him. The rest of the nations are supposed to serve him underneath the Israelites. That was the chosen people, man. Why you mean Isaiah 44 and 1? Let me show you something real quick. Isaiah 44 and 1.
Listen, man, I gotta go. I really
do. All right, man. Hey, man. All right, brother. Repeat. Check that out. Right. And repeat. Keep the commandments, man. You'll learn, right? So, nevertheless, man, let's get into it, man. Yeah, it's going down, man. First and foremost, I'm going to give all honor and all glory to Yahweh. Vashimah Mashiach Yahushua. Right? Hey, we the Hebrew Israelites, we come in week in and week out to prophesy the downfall of this wicked, nasty kingdom, man, known as America, man. Rebuke your wicked 4th of July celebration, man. Right? And tell you Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, it's time to wake up, man, and come back to your true biblical nationality. Hey, sister, you got 2 minutes to hear the words of the Lord? Come see us real quick. Right? Because see, what we got to understand is, you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, y'all not free. There's no independence for you, man. Right? Break out that definition of independence real quick, man. Right? Oh, okay. Here, right. I'm gonna show y'all something, man, what true independence actually is, man. Right? Because our people, for some reason, feel like we're independent, man. What does it mean to be independent, man? Right? You're still subject to slavery. Give me that 3:8 real quick. right? You're still subject to payments in these last days, man. You're still among the heathen. Read that.
This is the definition of independence. The fact of or state of being independent, self-government.
What did he say?
Self-government, self-rule. It says sovereignty, freedom, or autonomy.
See that? So what autonomy do you have, black and Hispanics, man? What freedom and rule? What nation do you have, man? What army do you have? What city do you have? Every city that you established here in America's, man, Babylon the Great, was destroyed by your oppressors, man.
Right?
Right? You still to this day on the modern day's plantation, man. Right? What they say, plant one, plant two, you work in finishing, you work in shipping. You still on the modern day plantation, man. So what do you mean freedom? There's no freedom for you, black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. The only freedom you get is by repenting and coming back to the Most High, man, and returning as an Israelite, man. That's the only freedom that you have. Right? Read that, Baruch.
This is the book of Baruch, chapter 3 and verse 8.
Right? I got a couple minutes, family.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
What the Lord say?
We are yet this day in our captivity.
Right.
Where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse.
What's going on, King? You got 2 minutes in the words of the Lord, man. Right? Hey, well, repeat, keep the commandments. The black, Hispanic, the Native Americans are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of, man. We ain't got no dealings with this 4th of July. You still a slave in this land, Doc. You not free, man.
Right?
Repent, come back to the Most High, man, in these last days, man. You ain't got nothing to do with this place, man. Right? So the Lord said, look, you are yet this day in your captivity, man. Right? You subject to payments, man, among the heathen, man, among these dogs, man. They still got their food on your neck, man. They can come kick your door out anytime they want to, man, and lock you up. They can take your kids from you, man, right? They can put a false flag against you, man, and lock you up for madness, right? But yet you out here amongst these people talking about independence or freedom. Freedom for what? What are you free from, man?
Right?
Give me Proverbs 1 and 20, man. What's going on? What's your nationality, brother? You got 2 minutes? Hey. Hey, all right, man. Well, big kids commandments, man. You for the tribe of Ephraim, bro. Right? Give me Proverbs 1 and 20.
I got it right. This is the Proverbs chapter 1 and verse 20. And it reads, it says, wisdom cries without. She uttereth her voice in the streets.
Right.
She crieth in the chief place of concourse,
right,
in the openings of the gates. In the city, she uttereth her word, saying, how long, ye simple ones,
what she say?
How long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity?
So the Lord said, how long, you simple black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, are you going to love simplicity, man? Y'all love to be out here among these damn nasty heathens, man, walking around celebrating a damn flag that got your ancestors' blood all over, man.
Right?
Right? Representing the nation, man. Right? Look, dog drawing out the mouth, man. Wicked as hell, man. Right? You falling, you in damn exile, man, out of your land and somebody else's backyard, man. Right? Celebrating their nastiness. Right? This land is drenched with the blood of your ancestors, man.
Right.
But yet you want to say equal. Equal to who, man? Who would have ever you been equal to the white man? Right? To the Asian man. Right? To the East Indian man, the Arab man. Since when have you ever been equal to these people, man? You've always been less than. But the Lord said he got something for America, man. He got a surprise for you damn devils out here, man. You damn crackers that's out here happy, go lucky, you doing your damn thing, man. You running around, you listening to our music, man. You know what I'm saying? You enjoying an evening of nice fun and pork hot dogs, man, and all type of wickedness, man. The Lord got something for you. Matter of fact, give me Revelation chapter 18. It started verse 3.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 18 and verse 3.
Uh-huh.
For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of fornication.
Right.
And the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her.
Right.
And the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of our delicacies.
And that's exactly what's happening, man. These nations are waxing rich on the abundance of the delicacies of this wicked nation, man. And everybody's drunk by the philosophy, the wisdom, the madness, and the foolishness of this country, man. Read.
Right? Verse 4, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, Come out of her, my people.
What the law say?
Come out of her, my people.
Right.
That you be not partakers of her sins, and that you receive not of her plagues.
Right, because the Lord said there's plagues coming upon this place, man. And the Lord is asking that you blame Hispanic and Native Americans to come out of. Hey, brother, you got 2 minutes to hear the words of the Lord, King? You got 2 minutes? Oh, well, they ignore their brothers, but they want to celebrate with the white man, right? They want to celebrate with the white man, but they don't care about their brothers, though. Right? Read on.
Verse 5. For her sins have reached unto heaven, and the Most High have remembered her iniquities.
Right.
Reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her double according to her works.
And that's what the Lord is about to do. He remembered everything you've done. He remembered the Civil War, man. He remembered slavery, lynching, great robbing, buck breaking, and murdering, man.
Right.
Slaughtering. You stealing children, man. Stealing women, man. The Lord remembers that. Give me Psalm 49:11. The Lord remembers everything you've done, man. All the war that you've caused on this earth, man. Even the animal cruelty, man. How you pollute the waters, man. You pollute the air. The Lord remembers everything you've done. Read.
Come. It reads, in the cup which she has filled, filled to her double. How much she has glorified herself and lived deliciously. So much torment and sorrow give her.
What the Lord say?
So much torment and sorrow give her.
The Lord says so much torment and sorrow he's going to give to so-called Babylon the Great. Hey, AKA America, man.
That's right.
You're going to receive thermonuclear fire. You're going to receive plagues. You're going to receive famine, man. You're going to receive civil war, man. While you out here enjoying your time, man, you thinking these days are just going to keep going and you're going to wax old and keep waxing rich in this place, man. But the Lord said, no way, man. Read that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 49, verse 11.
Bring it out.
Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations.
And that's what they think, man. Y'all think that your dwelling place is going to come and it's going to continue to happen, man. You think that you're going to continue to reign supreme on the earth, man, that everybody's going to bow to your will. But Babylon, the Lord said, he got something for you, man. Finish up.
And it reads, and their dwelling places do dwell to all generations. They call their lands after their own name.
And see, that's what they've done. The white man, Americo Vespucci, he came over here and claimed his place, man. How y'all doing, brother? You got 2 minutes to hear the words of the Lord, King? You're an Israelite, man. You're a God chosen people. You got to hear this word, man. It's about you, right? Repent, keep the commandments, man. You're an Israelite, man, right? Read on in that.
Come. It reads, it says, for she saith in her heart, I said a queen.
You see that?
And am no widow, and shall see no sorrow.
And that's what they say, man. They feel like they're never going to see any sorrow, man. You sit as a queen, man. That nasty damn Statue of Liberty sitting over there at damn Liberty Island, man, in New York, man, is going to be burnt to a crisp, man, when the Lord get through with you, man. Read.
Gone. Verse 8. Therefore shall her plagues come in one day. Death and mourning and famine. And she shall be utterly burned with fire.
Right.
For strong is Yahweh who judges her.
And the Lord said, hey, he's going to send plagues and famine and torment to this place called America, man, because of your sins, man, have reached the heavens, man.
That's right.
And this place is not going to exist anymore on the planet, man.
That's right.
And the people around you are going to rejoice. And the angels in heaven going to say, whoa, 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 is unto you, man. Babylon the Great has fallen, man. Right. And you're going to receive the plagues that the Lord has, man, right? And you should never be among these people, man, because guess what? Your independence has not come. Your independence is when you return back to your land, man. Then you'll have sovereignty, man, right? Then you'll have peace, right? Give me 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14 real quick, right? That's what peace looks like, man. Read that.
This is the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14. Right? And it reads, 2 Chronicles 7 and 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray.
And what?
And pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways.
And do what?
And turn from their wicked ways. Then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land.
And that's when you receive peace, man. It's when your land is healed, man. When you return and repent from your wickedness, man, and your foolishness, man, and come back to the Lord and keep these law statutes, commandments, that's when the peace is going to come for you, man. But the Lord said right now, what the Lord say, read that.
Book of Nehemiah chapter 3, verse 1. Woe unto the bloody city.
What the Lord say?
Woe unto the bloody city.
It
is all full of lies and robbery.
Right. What's going on, King? You got 2 minutes to hear the words of the Lord, man? Hey man, repent, keep the commandments. You're an Israelite, man, that the Bible speaks of. Stay away from these complications. That's not for you. You're not independent, man.
Right?
Read that again. You two sisters, y'all beautiful sisters of Zion, man. Y'all gotta stay away from stuff like this, man. The Lord said, abstain from all appearances of evil.
Right?
You're not free. You're still a slave in this land, man. Right? Read.
Woe unto the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery.
Uh-huh.
The prey departeth not.
And then, hey, the Lord said, woe to the bloody city. It's full of what? Lies and robbery. What do they call it? Fourth of you lie, man. There's no independence for you black, Hispanic, Native Americans. Yes, you white people, y'all got independence from Britain. Yeah, y'all got your own land and sovereignty, man. But how did you achieve that? May I ask you that question? How did you get freedom in this land? How did you get freedom in this land? Yeah, how did you get freedom in this land? Uh-huh. But how did your ancestors get freedom in this land? They what? They invaded this land, man. And that's why I say, read that again.
Woe unto the bloody city.
Uh-huh.
It is all full of lies and robbery.
Full of what?
For the prey departed not.
Right, so the Lord said it's full of lies and robbery. The man just said that they took it. They took this land, man.
Right.
They stole this land from the Native Americans, man.
Right.
But now they got a holiday called Independence Day, man. Right? That they're on a stolen land that's full of lies. When you in school, you learn lies about their ancestors, right? Their kings, their governors, their rulers. But what about yours, Israel?
Right.
What about your kings and rulers? Can't not one black person name a king or a ruler of your own people, man. Black folks don't even know your own history past the 1600s, man.
That's right.
You just woke up and was a slave one day. How did that happen? You was created a slave. Hey, sister. What's your nationality, man? What's your nationality?
White.
What you doing with my sister, man?
Black.
Huh? Now, I see that. You a precious daughter of Zion. If you a so-called black woman, you'll be from the tribe of Judah, of the nation of Israel, man. That's what the Bible speaks of, man. The people that walked through the Red Sea with Moses, that is our people. That's our ancestors. Man. We never been taught that. But now the truth of the Bible is about to come out, man. That your ancestors was King David, the one they call Jesus Christ, which is a black man, not the white man, right? That we've been lied to. That's our blood, our heritage. And the Lord said we have to come out from among these people and be separate. Because this is not you're not independent, sister. You're still a slave in this land, man.
That's right.
Right? You're not equal to these people, man. Never been and never will be until we get back in our own land, man. Thus said the Lord, repent as an Israelite, man. Right? And separate from your enemy, man. Right? So nevertheless, man, like I said, this place is built off of robbery, man. Matter of fact, give me Numbers 35 to 33 real quick.
I'm already on it.
Yeah, read that. Kind of read it.
Numbers chapter 35, verse 33.
Uh-huh.
It reads, so ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are.
Right.
For blood it defileth the land.
What the Lord say?
For blood it defileth the land.
So I'm gonna ask a question. Is not blood defiled this land? Is not that that flag that y'all waving so proudly? Is it not drenched with blood?
Right.
Of my ancestors, man? Read.
God. For blood it defileth the land.
Uh-huh.
And it reads, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it.
The Lord said this land cannot be cleansed, but by the blood of him that shed it, man. Right? This land can't be cleansed, man. There's no way, because there's so much rape, robbery, and murder, man, and thievery and trickery in this land, that this land is defiled to no end, man. And it's a stench in the nose of the Most High, man.
Right?
He's not dealing with this, man. Right? He's not smelling this wicked, nasty feast day, man. Right? And the Lord said the blood defiled this land, but this land will not be cleansed but by the blood of him that shed it, man. Read that.
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 19.
Uh-huh.
Egypt shall be a desolation.
Right.
And Edom shall be a desolate wilderness.
Exactly what's about to happen. Spiritual Egypt, man, which is America, is about to be a desolation. Hey, brother, you got a minute to hear the words of the Lord real quick? You got 2 minutes? You believe in the Bible? You believe in the Bible? What you know about the Bible? What you know about the Israelites, brother? What you know about the Israelites? Just a question. Nothing, not too much. Right, well, hey.
He turned us Israel isn't God's chosen people anymore. Jesus opened the kingdom to the Gentiles. All the Gentiles can be saved by Christ.
That's a lie. We can cut that right now with the Bible, right? So check this out. Well, come get the Bible then. Come get this Bible. Right? So anyway, right? So listen. The Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans are the true biblical Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Those are our ancestors, right? Those are, we are those that walk through the valley, the Red Sea, right, with Moses, right? Our ancestors are Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? And the one they call Christ, man, right? Christ is not this guy right here, man. That's the false depiction of Christ. He's actually a Black man. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah, I know.
You knew that? See that? That's right. So guess what, man? What we teach, man, is the biblical Israelites, we have to repent and return back to the commandments of God.
Right.
The reason why you're in this land called America, aka Babylon the Great, is because our sins have separated us from our God. And we got cast into utter darkness, into captivity, man. It's slavery. And that's in the Bible. Let me show that. Give me Deuteronomy 28. Right? Let me show that 15 and then 68. Right? Read that.
Listen to this. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15.
Right?
It reads, but it shall come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Lord said, look, he told the Israelites when they came out of Egypt, he said, I'm going to give you commandments. And if you refuse to keep my commandments, then I'm going to place curses on you. So know that the Israelites fell away from the Most High, and they began to sin and serve other gods and things of that nature. So the curses were placed on the people. And I'm going to show you the main curse that was placed on our people, man. Read that.
Verse 28, it reads, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
So remember, when we was in Egypt, we was what? Captives. We was slavery, right? And I can prove that with the Bible, because when the Lord speaks to us, he speaks to us in similitude. He said, I'm going to bring you into another Egypt. Why read that?
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage. So Egypt is equivalent with bondage, right? So read that.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
How do we get to the side of the earth, man? Ships, right? That's in the Bible, man. This was written 4,000 years ago, King. Right? So the Lord prophesied, since you're going to fall away from my commandments, I'm going to send you into another slavery or slave ships, man. Right? Read.
Come, by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. Uh-huh. And there you shall be sold.
You shall be what?
You shall be sold unto your enemies.
Unto your enemies. So we got off of this boat, who was we sold to? Who? White man, right? So he said they were your enemies. So I got a question. Is this your why are you with your enemies, man? Why are you amongst your enemies, man? You got to think about that. What caused you to do that? Give me 17. Listen to this and read that.
This book is Sirach, chapter 12 and verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
What the Lord say?
Never trust thine enemy. For like his iron rusted, so it's his wickedness.
So eventually, man, the Lord said, look, don't trust your enemies, because eventually, if you do one thing wrong, them devil horns is going to show.
That's right.
And you might end up locked up or dead somewhere, or hung in a tree. It's just the truth. So you got to what? Read.
Sirach 6 and verse 13. Separate thyself from thine enemies.
What the Lord said?
Separate thyself from thine enemies. And take heed of thy friends.
So the Lord said, you got to separate from him, man, for this last day. You got to get away from him, man. Because see, not for you. You got 12 tribes to pick from, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to repeat these commandments, man.
That's right.
Right? So what you think about that, King? Yeah. You're here, so you going to do it?
I don't know about that.
You don't know about what? So you know that's your enemy, but you still going to be amongst them. Wow. That's off as hell, brother. So basically, you made a covenant with death, man. That's very insane. That's what insanity is, doing the same thing over and over again. Nothing's gonna happen different, brother. You know, but you gotta make it. You gotta change, man. You gotta renew your mind. That's what changing is. Renewing your mind, being born again, coming back to the commandments and repenting from your sin, right? And returning as an Israelite man. Taking on an Israelite woman. Let me read to you. I'm going to give you Tobit 4 and 12. Check this out. Right, read that.
This is the book of Tobit, chapter 4 and verse 12. Tobit's up to 4 and verse 12. And it reads, beware of all whoredom, my son, and chiefly take a wife of the seed of thy fathers.
The Lord said, chiefly take a wife of the seed of your fathers. Read.
And take not a strange woman to wife.
A what?
A strange woman to wife.
Read.
Which is not of thy father's tribe.
So it's clear she's not of your father's tribe, man. So the Lord said, don't take a strange woman to wife, man. You got to chiefly take a wife of the seed of your fathers, man. Right? Because the Lord ain't dealing with confusion or mixing. Right? He dealing with his people only, man. Right? So you got to take heed of the warning, man. Right? You got to understand it. Matter of fact, give me read that. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 9.
Right.
Thou shalt not sow thy vineyard with diverse seeds.
Right.
Lest the fruit of thy seed which thou hast sown and the fruit of thy vineyard be defiled.
And that's what happens, man, when you have those so-called mixed babies. They become defiled. Then they become confused because they with you as a family and over here with your family learning something. Now they over here with moms and her family. Now they learning something different. 9 times out of 10 is lies. Right. Now they confused. They don't know what's going on out here, man. And it's defiled. The Lord is not the author of confusion, man. He said, let's do everything decently and in order, man.
Right?
So we got to do those things in order, man, to teach our people, man, that we got to come back to the commandments, man, and repent. That's the so-called the Black, Hispanic, Native Americans, all the Israelites, man, that the Bible speaks of, man. Right? Take heed to that warning, man. Read.
This is because I read chapter 37 and verse 12. But be continually with a godly man.
What the Lord say?
Be continually with a godly man whom thou knowest to keep the commandments of the Lord.
Right, and that's vice versa, man. Be continually with a godly man or with a godly woman, one that you know is going to keep the commandments of the Most High God. And who was the commandments given to? Israel, man. That's the only people that was given to, man. Right? And nobody else. Right? So guess what? It's time to return and repent as the people of the Most High, man, and stop playing, man, with the Lord. Right? Give me Psalm 65 and 21. Right? I'm going to pass here in a minute.
We got all this kind of Psalms 55 and verse 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter. But war was in his heart.
But war was in his heart. And that's the problem, man. We get sucked in by being beguiled by the so-called white man, these Edomites, man, because they say that they love you, man,
right?
And we're your friends, and you can come and join us at our so-called Independence Day, and hey, man, and take care of, and take part of our festivities, man. Wave the flag, watch the pretty sparkles about to happen in the air, man, right? But the Lord said war is in his heart, man. The whole time they plotting on you, man. They look at you as less than a dog, man. You're nothing to them, man. They can say all that, man, that's not true, man. We like black people. Well, I got one black friend. You know, they all say that, man. But they full of crap, man. They full of lies, man. Distortion, deceit, trickery, man. And the Lord said war was in his heart, man. Right? And woe to this bloody city that's full of blood and is about to be exposed, man. Right? Give me one more. Give me Exodus chapter 21 and verse 16. Right? And you give me Romans 13 and 11. One of y'all. Read it.
Exodus chapter 21 and verse 16. And he that stealeth the man and selleth him, or if he be found in his hand, he shall surely be put to death.
So when were you ever given back, man? When were you ever, matter of fact, give me that Jeremiah 50 and 33, right? When were you ever let go, man, from captivity, man? The Lord said, he that stealeth a man and selleth a man, what happened to you, Black, Hispanic, Native American? You were stolen and you were sold, man.
Right?
And if you be found in a hand still, guess what? Your oppressors get put to death, man, thus saith the Lord. And that's what's coming for this wicked-ass kingdom, right? Read that.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 50 and verse 33. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together. And all that took them captives held them fast.
They did what?
Held them fast.
And what?
They refused to let them go.
So guess what, man? You Black, Hispanic, Native Americans, you are still in captivity to this day, man. So this Independence Day is not for you, man. You got to separate from your enemies, man, and come out of this wicked, nasty land, man, right? And be now partakers of this evil, right? It's time to wake up as so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans and understand that you are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of,
that's
man.
Right. Right?
Read that.
It's the book of Romans, chapter 13 and verse 11. And that knowing that the time that now is high time to awake out of sleep.
Right.
For now is our salvation nearer than we believe.
And it's time for you Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans to wake out of sleep, man, and come off among these damn devils and know, hey, guess what? Our salvation is nearer than what we believe, man. World War III is almost here, man. Y'all keep playing games, you're going to get caught up with a nuke right up your behind, man. Right? You're going to get caught up in civil war. You're going to get caught up in a famine, man, if you do not repent and come back to the Most High, man.
That's right.
In these last days, your Independence Day is going to be rained on by thermonuclear weapons, man. Putin is gearing up. These other nations are about to come together and destroy Babylon the Great, a.k.a. your Americas, man. Right? Read that.
This is the book of Joshua, chapter 24, and verse 15.
Uh-huh.
And if it seem evil unto you to serve Yahweh,
what the Lord say?
If it seem evil unto you to serve Yahweh, choose you this day whom you will serve.
Right.
Whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell.
Right.
But as for me and my house,
what the Lord say?
As for me and my house, we will serve Yahweh.
Man, for as the commandment keeping, faith having Israelites, man, we're going to serve Yahweh by sending me out, man. But with that, boom, that's up.
Boom,
that's up.
Boom, that's up.
Boom, the Shalom.
It's a stony road that I'm walking. No company, no company. All the voices in my head won't stop it. My only company, my only company.
Blood off my hands, the judgment coming fast, too much blood on his lane. The second exodus is about to happen, he playing. He's sending out the winds, on this rock we gon' stand. We gon' trust the son of man. This the final hour, was disconnected from the source. We done found the power, Messiah built the church back. Gotta trust the founder, the carpenter. Got the fiber with him, ain't no stopping you. Protected by the winds, if you got his heart with you. Staying on the narrow, the father gon' provide. Y'all his eyes on the sparrow. Never seen the righteous get forsaken, not at all. The devil trying to take, cause he know he about to fall. And Michael standing up in his hour, keep the laws. We gon' blow the trumpet, we ain't go to war with all. Messiah made a way, he laid it down for all flaws. We got the father with his eye up, stand tall. Protecting these commands, they at war with him. The dragon man, cause the remnant about to score with him. The children of the prophets, we done finally hockey. The law is the light, got us out the darkness. Return to the father, ain't no other options. We let Messiah in, we done heard him knocking. Worthy is the Lamb, ain't no better time, surrender all right now. ain't no looking back. You ain't lot wife, hell no. Fit for the kingdom, ain't no way that he gon' fail, y'all. Training up his kids, ain't no way we gon' derail, y'all. The devil making war with the saints, man, he smell, y'all. We gon' go to war about these commandments to the end. Protect my father, word, this ain't no game, this ain't pretend. Messiah coming back, we study yet and I repent. The mangers on the corner, finally blowing out the wing. Ain't no other way to get protected but the blue. I'll put your mercy and your grace around us. Keeping these commandments, cause we know that's real love. Building up this ark, cause you sent it out of flow. What you see is hand upon this land, it's time to leave. Sodom and Gomorrah out of order, time to flee. Babylon gon' burn every nation about the sea. Messiah coming back, everybody to their knees. Every knee gon' bow. Boy, girl, child, y'all, he coming in the clouds. Thousands of years, man, it's almost time now. The valley of the drought, we done came alive now. This for every nigga you done hung, every baby you done raped, everything that you done. Ain't no way you gon' escape, ain't no way that you gon' run. You gon' see him face to face with a hill, Babylon, but we can't.